over 20 hours of testimony from Peter Strzok, who was named by the president there. You also met with Lisa Page, a lawyer at the FBI involved with this Friday. I think you're meeting with her again tomorrow. In your investigations, have you seen any evidence of an anti-Trump bias at the FBI?
Sure. An anti-Trump bias? Absolutely. You just mentioned two of them, Strzok and Page. I mean, Strzok was biased against Trump before he began investigating him. Of course, on August the 6th, he promised to stop his candidacy. On the 15th, he talked about an insurance policy. I think the most damning piece of evidence, Margaret, with respect to bias is the day Bob Mueller was announced. Special Agent Peter Strzok wasn't talking about indictments like you and I just were. He wasn't talking about defending the country like you and I are. He's talking about impeaching the president. That is an unprecedented level of bias. Now, how pervasive it was beyond those two, I think there are four or five other unidentified bureau and department agents and employees who also had bias, but there are 13,000 FBI agents and 99.9% of them are doing exactly what you would want them to do and exactly the way you would want them to do it.
Well, that's a point here, though, that seems to be getting lost, or at least when the president is speaking, he's conflating these specific individuals, the number you put four or five, with the entire intelligence organization that is the FBI, and there is some concern that that is corrosive to our democracy. Do you fear that your hearing is being used in that way?
Well, our private hearing was much more constructive than the public hearing. I mean, public hearings are a circus, Margaret. I mean, that's why I don't like to do them. I don't do many of them. I mean, it's a freak show. I mean, the private interviews are much more constructive. But I would also say this. I mean, put yourself in President Trump's shoes for just a second. Jim Comey thought that impeachment was too good for you. John Brennan says you should be in the dustbin of history. Those are not insignificant people. One headed the FBI, the other headed the CIA when you were under investigation. The lead FBI agent said that you would be destabilizing for the country and promised to stop your candidacy. I mean, Margaret, if you were being investigated,